When you've forgotten your passcode and your iPhone becomes disabled, you have to erase it and set it up as new.
Other than waiting and then entering the correct passcode, this is the only way to get back into your iPhone. Unless you've already entered your passcode 10 times incorrectly, in which case your iPhone is completely disabled.
We'll explain how to erase your iPhone and then give you some tips to help protect it in the future, because a lot of the time, it's not you that locked yourself out. The first way to erase your iPhone is using your computer and recovery mode. Step one is turn off your iPhone. So I'm gonna press and hold the side button and the volume down button. Swipe, slide to power off. Phone is turning off.
Even if your iPhone is unavailable, you could still turn it off.
Now that it's off, we're going to enter recovery mode.
And we need three things for this to work. A computer, doesn't have to be yours, a cable, and your iPhone.
Step one, I'm gonna plug this cable into my computer. And as I plug in the Lightning connector into my phone, I'm gonna press and hold the side button. You do that on any iPhone 8 or newer. If you have an iPhone 7, press and hold the volume down button as you're plugging in. If you have an iPhone 6S or older, press and hold the home button as you're plugging in. So press and hold the side button, plug in the cable. Gonna keep pressing and holding. Apple logo is going to appear on the screen. Keep pressing and holding. You can let go of your button once you see the computer and the cable icon appear on the phone.
The rest of the process happens on your computer. If you're using an older Mac with 10.14 or older, or you're using an older PC nowadays, you're gonna use iTunes. If you're using a newer Mac, you're gonna use Finder. If you're using a newer PC, it's gonna be the Apple Devices app.
Let's open Finder on this computer and locate the phone underneath Locations. There's a problem with the iPhone that requires it to be updated or restored. We're gonna click the Restore button,
which incidentally will update it.
Yep. Are you sure you want to restore the iPhone to its factory settings? All media and other data will be erased and the newest version of the iPhone software will be installed. So click Restore and Update.
You don't have another option. If there's a company that offers to help you bypass this, don't trust them. It doesn't work. It's a scam.
You'll get some information about the update. Just click Next. Then read the agreement, obviously, start to finish. Then click Agree. And we're now downloading the iPhone software update.
You'll see a progress bar going across the screen at the bottom. First, it downloads the file, then it extracts it, then your computer updates your iPhone. The restore process itself will take about 10 minutes, but this process is gonna take anywhere between 1 minute and a million minutes, depending on how fast your internet connection.
Depends how fast your internet speeds are, how large the update is. Could be a big thing. If it's a major update, it's gonna take longer to download. The download is complete and now it says extracting software at the bottom of the screen. Just keep watching those status bars. Now we've got our candy cane.
Depressing candy cane.
Depressing candy cane status bar. Preparing iPhone for restore. You'll notice the Apple logo has now appeared on the screen. We've got a status bar on our iPhone as well. Status bars to look at.
Yes.
As we're waiting for these status bars to roll along, consider hitting that join button below this video. Obviously, right now, you can't edit any of the settings on your iPhone, but if you become a member of our channel, we've got PDFs of our settings that we recommend changing. You can get those and a whole lot more. Click on that join button below. So when your restore is finished, you can go in, change all the settings.
As soon as the process finishes and you see iPhone locked to owner on your phone, you might have to tap the screen to get that to show up. You can unplug it from your computer and the whole rest of the process happens on the iPhone itself.
On the iPhone locked to owner page, swipe up to open, tap on your language, select your country or region. You can quick start or set up manually. We're gonna choose set up manually. Choose our Wi-Fi network. It may take a few minutes for your phone to activate. Next, we need to enter our Apple ID and password, then tap next upper right-hand corner of the screen. There we go. Now we're in data and privacy. Tap continue. Face ID, we'll set that up later. You can set it up now if you'd like. And create a new passcode. Make sure it's one that you do not forget. So we're gonna choose this one. If you choose a password that'll be easily guessed, you might get this pop-up saying this passcode can be easily guessed. Take that risk at your own discretion. We're gonna use that anyway. And we'll enter one more time. Next, choose if you want to transfer apps and data to this phone. We have an iCloud backup. We're going to select Restore from iCloud Backup. With your iCloud account, tap Next, upper right-hand corner of the screen, enter your passcode one more time, and tap Next, upper right-hand corner of the screen. Apple ID verification code.
Then you must find another device.
Okay. You only see this pop up if two-factor authentication is on. It probably is on your phone, so There it is. Once again, we got more terms and conditions that you should definitely read start to finish. Then once you've done that, tap agree, lower right-hand corner of the screen. It may take a few minutes to set up your Apple ID. Now that we're on the choose backup page, choose your most recent backup. Make this your new iPhone, tap continue. We'll set up Apple Pay later in wallet. Apple beta program, we're continuing that.
You beta believe it.
Now we're on restore from iCloud. Are you sick of progress bars? Well, too bad, you got one more to sit through. And we did it. It took a little while, but we are back into our phone. If I swipe up and I can log in again, thanks to the iCloud backup, all my apps are there. You can also erase your iPhone wirelessly using your computer. So we're gonna go to iCloud.com/find. We're gonna sign into our account. Once you're logged into iCloud Find My, click on your device, iPhone, locating.
If you don't see it right away, you could tap the little triangle next to all devices at the top and find it in that list.
There it is. We got our iPhone. Click on the Erase iPhone button. Erase this iPhone. All content and settings will be erased. If Find My Network is enabled, you'll still be able to locate this iPhone. Then click Erase. Enter your password, follow the instructions, and you're good to go. Let's talk about how to future-proof your iPhone. Step one, turn on iCloud backup.
That way you know you'll have a backup if your iPhone becomes disabled again.
Maybe you have small children who love pressing buttons, or a nosy sibling who can't read your diary anymore because nobody writes in diaries anymore.
Or a YouTube co-host who likes to play pranks on you every day.
Open the Settings app and tap on your Apple ID at the top of the screen, then tap iCloud, tap iCloud Backup, and make sure the switch next to backup this iPhone is on.
iCloud Backup automatically happens every day as long as your iPhone is plugged in, the screen is off, and you're connected to Wi-Fi or cellular data, but we tell you to turn that off.
Definitely turn off the switch next to backup over cellular. This will just drain your cellular data plan.
Next, we're gonna turn on Find My so that if your iPhone becomes disabled again, you can just wirelessly erase it and find it, I suppose.
Let's tap back to the main page of our Apple ID settings, then tap on Find My. Tap on Find My iPhone at the top of the screen and make sure the switch next to Find My iPhone is on.
The next setting to be aware of is Erase Data.
Let's head back to the main page of settings. Scroll down to Face ID and Passcode. Log in using your passcode that you now remember because your phone is unlocked. Then scroll all the way down to Erase Data. When this is on, your iPhone automatically erases your data after 10 failed passcode attempts.
Not as important for parents as it is for secret agents whose phones might get stolen.
But this next tip is really helpful for parents with those annoying little children. It's a setting called Guided Access.
Kids love to press buttons, especially buttons with numbers on them. I remember pressing a lot of buttons in elevators when I was a kid. People loved that.
Let's head back to the main page of settings, scroll all the way to the top, and then we're gonna type in Guided Access. First result there, tap on Guided Access. Takes you right to it, no tapping involved. Let's turn on that switch next to Guided Access.
Guided Access locks your iPhone in a specific app so that if you hand it to somebody like a kid, they can't lock it and then press all the buttons and disable your iPhone again.
Let's say you want to lock your child inside the YouTube app. Let's close out of settings. Come over here to our app library. I'll type in YouTube, open that up. And then we're going to triple click the side button. 1, 2, 3. Then tap Guided Access. And now they are locked inside that Guided Access. Just tap start, upper right hand corner of the screen. Set a passcode. Don't forget it. And you are all set. Guided Access started. Triple click the side button to exit.
Right. So then you have to enter that Guided Access passcode again. Your kids can't lock you out of your entire phone.
Yep. To leave Guided Access, I'll triple click the side button again. Enter my passcode. And we're done. Tap end upper left hand corner of the screen. Guided Access ended.
Give Daddy the phone back, Johnny. Give Daddy his phone back. Otherwise, as David said, he's going to lock you in a closet or something.
And now that you've gotten your phone back, learn how to keep hackers out too by watching our next video.